This is a low-power histological image of a Spitz naevus. Older terms for Spitz naevus include benign juvenile melanoma and spindle and epitheliod cell naevus. They are benign melanocytic tumours that tend to occur in children and young adults, although about half of them occur in people over the age of 14 and a quarter of them over the age of 30. They're more frequent in females than males, and they tend to affect the face and extremities. Spitz naevus is normally solitary, and the appearance is that of a domed and hairless pink or occasionally pigmented lesion that is well circumscribed, usually less than 6 millimetres in diameter, and less than 95% are over 1 centimetre across. Because of the pink appearance, Spitz naevus may resemble a pyogenic granuloma. Histologically, most Spitz naevi have the architecture of a compound naevus, with spindle cells and epitheliod cells in varying proportions. The cells have abundant pale cytoplasm, and the nuclei may be pleomorphic with occasional mitotic figures. The nests of cells tend to be arranged perpendicular to the epidermis, and melanin is usually absent, and that is why a Spitz naevus has a pink appearance resembling a pyogenic granuloma. Other useful histological features of Spitz naevi include a typically perivascular lymphoid infiltrate, the naevus cells maturing with depth, and artifactual clefts appearing at the dermo-epidermal junction, and here there may also be Kamino bodies. These are PAS-positive globules. All these features are useful in differentiating a Spitz naevus from a nodular malignant melanoma that it may resemble because of the nuclear pleomorphism and occasional mitotic activity, although there won't be abnormal mitotic figures in a Spitz naevus like there would be in a melanoma. Here is a low-power view of a Spitz naevus. It has a nodular configuration, and one thing that is quite obvious is that the Spitz naevus is well demarcated from the adjacent dermis. Here is a mild lymphoid infiltrate that is another feature of a Spitz naevus. Here is a tongue of spindle cells arranged perpendicular to the epidermis, and as the tongue descends into the deeper dermis, the naevus cells start to resemble more conventional naevus cells, become less spindled and smaller. Here, just below the epidermis, the naevus cells have a more epithelioid appearance, and at the epidermodermal junction, at the right of the picture, is a tiny hyaline globule consistent with a small Kamino body.